Oh, it's June 2013, and I'm Chris Fabbri. I'm gonna make a little video here, and I'm gonna talk about the portraits I've been doing my whole life. I've been painting basically for the last 30 years, consistently, non-stop. Sometimes 50 paintings a year, sometimes 100, sometimes just, you know, a few. But I began in 87, 88, just looking at family members, before and after school, just being very conscientious of the fact that I'm measuring when I do a portrait, because if the measuring is not correct, it starts to look like something else than your subject. But when I was young, I believed that I could draw anything and paint anything. Whereas when I got older now, it's become more of a challenge. Here I'm looking at my artwork on my iTouchpad, and I can refer to certain images. But if I just start back in my earliest days, I really enjoyed profiles, looking at someone from the side. I worked in the Garden Museum, and so I was surrounded in Boston, so I was surrounded by beautiful portraits. So I got to study Rembrandt, Degas, Sargent, Anders Zorn, all the great masters, Titian. So I was surrounded by so much work that I started to do sketches in the museum when I could. Here's some of them if you can. They're in my earliest file. So then I just started to produce work for friends, and the portraits I did became so sentimental and referred to stuff such as like my religion and Catholicism. But as I got older, I wanted to do, let's say, influential people that were still living, musicians. I was very, back in, let's say, before I moved to California, I was still studying figure drawing. In figure drawing, you learn muscle tone and weight balance, contour and twisting. But, you know, painting and drawing is sort of a little different, but drawing gives you that measurement right down to detail, whereas painting, I think you can still measure, but you're loose brush strokes, so you can capture light, and you can capture just the way there's light in the shade, which brings out just an emotion in work. So if you look at my site, you'll just, and go to the portraits file, I have a gallery, and then I break it up into the dating, the dates, such as like the early 80s, 90s, and into the millennium. I break that up into a little bit of the liturgicals, portraits of people who are such as abbots that I got commissions for to do at the Nuclevo Abbey. And that was a blessing, because I think a lot of people are looking at the way I painted these abbots with such realism in the cheekbones and eyes looking at you or directly, with such happiness, smiling, and they're proud to wear their habits and wear their cross. So that was just really good work for me, I believe, and it actually shows my early style, I think. And so if you look around my site, you'll be surrounded by, let's say, pop art. Some of my favorite actors and actresses, you know, people that left us movies and great films to study the way such easy smiles and easy, let's say, postures they use in their movies and in their, let's say, a still movie or a silent movie with like Charlie Chaplin, or let's say like a live concert with Bob Marley, or you know, you can really, when you look around through my portfolio, I've really dabbed and grabbed into like what I think is from me, like growing up in the 70s and 80s, and so I use, let's say, Star Wars and Elvis and people from the movie Grease. I mean, these are just like sort of like sentimental, they're like cheerful, and they kept me upbeat. But the way I've been painting is almost like with a monochromatic look, but then I'll add touches in with the color. My favorite color is yellow and flesh tones. But I break my portraits up into whether it's a portrait or an illustration. Illustration to me is like a cartoon, or it's telling a story. Whereas a portrait is just, you know, let's say John Lennon or Shirley Temple or Picasso or Marilyn Monroe, it's just looking at you. And the way they smile, the way they gesture their shoulders, is what I try to capture. So, I could go through all my work here and show and let you know about how I've been producing work, but it's sort of a secret where I sort of continue that measuring as I did as a kid. But now I'm using, let's say, colors and subject matter so seriously that it has to be Chris Fabbri. It has to be, or I just can't really do it. Like musicians and actors, or any type of illustrative person. Like, what I was starting to think of is that if I paint a portrait and it's on a box, or maybe the type of box, let's say macaroni and cheese box. Well, I put David Bowie on a macaroni and cheese box, and his hair is the macaroni. So, I mean, there's different concepts you can do, or if you paint the Scarecrow from Wizard of Oz on a Wheat Thins box, crackers box. Okay, so, there's some type of thought process in progressively using a traditional medium to move forward in. It's not just a painting, it's actually telling us something. It's actually making us think about the character painted. And I've been doing a lot of sculptural work. Like, the paintings are actually getting sculptural, like Marilyn Monroe's hair. I just put clumps of yellow paint. I've been doing renditions of Mona Lisa. And one rendition I did of her in 2009 is just a monochromatic look of her, where it's just four or five shades of gray. But I really got her squint and her smile, I believe. But then just recently, 2013, 5 years later, 4 years later, I did a portrait of her at the best I could in the style of Da Vinci, but you know, and had her looking at a laptop. So, in a way, it's letting you know that we're progressively using a traditional medium, but we're thinking more, I believe. Or maybe in this day and age, we're trying to look for reasons of why we're painting, why we are making music, why. So there's a message in a lot of this work. Mostly the message is to keep your eye at peace. A lot of pictures of just people modeling and letting people know that they love themselves and they want to be happy and they want to smile and so as I look through my work, I'm always correcting it, trying to make it look like it's for the better. I gotta thank so many people for letting me just practice with this stuff, and it's actually gotten me some money, and I've gotten paid a little bit through great commissions of people where I hope they just hold on to the artwork, you know. What else is more to do? Maybe it'll be in a gallery or museum. But I just wanted to sit down and film myself today. And this big guy helps. And a lot of things help. You be well. Enjoy this video.